tonight. Reaction from the BC Assembly of First Nations regarding the controversy surrounding the mayor of Quesnel and his wife. Plus, following a recent fatality on a motorcycle, RCMP are warning riders to drive defensively. And a big focus from the Wellness North and Business Expo this past weekend was supporting the mental and physical well-being of seniors. Good evening, folks. I'm Eddie Huband, and welcome to CKPG News. Our top story tonight follows up on a controversial story from Friday. The BC Assembly of First Nations is congratulating the Latako Dene Nation and the city of Quesnel for their work fighting against residential school denialism in Canada. This after it came to light that the wife of Quesnel's mayor was distributing denialist literature. Adam Burrell spoke with Regional Chief Terry Teagee to hear more about the BCAFN's reaction to the news. And a warning, some of the images in this story may be disturbing.
It was just under a week ago that Quesnel City Council found out that the wife of Quesnel's mayor was distributing the book Grave Error, a book which downplays the history of residential schools in Canada. After this information came to light, the BC Assembly of First Nations released a statement regarding residential school denialism in Quesnel.
I think the issue of denialism of residential schools and what residential schools did to First Nations peoples is quite disturbing, especially in this day and age after the Truth and Reconciliation Commission, thousands of findings and the experiences of many residential school survivors.
Denialism often focuses on errors in reporting or claims that students benefited from residential schools in an attempt to sow doubt about the reality of the extreme harms committed against Indigenous peoples by the residential school system. What took place in Quesnel, TG says, is that stories of those who experienced harm need to be protected.
Once again, here we are having to protect those stories and also really tell the truth, our truth, about what happened with these genocidal acts that were imposed on the Indigenous peoples and First Nations peoples here in Canada.
And Regional Chief Terry Teagee says that this issue that has sparked controversy across the city of Quesnel is much more than just about denialism.
The survivors brought forward these truths. And so to deny these truths is certainly a slap in the face of many First Nations peoples across this country, perhaps to Canada too, because really what we're trying to do here is reconcile a broken relationship with many First Nations people in this country.
TG says it will be important going forward that residential school denialism be condemned in Quesnel so that the city and the Latako Dene Nation can continue working towards reconciliation.
I think reaffirming their MOU to work on this relationship and perhaps really condemn the denialism that is coming from the mayor's wife and perhaps really rethink the mayor's position. I think it's really important to do that.
Since 2021, First Nations across Canada have found evidence of approximately 1,900 unmarked graves at 16 former residential schools, not including the 215 found at the former Kamloops Residential School. Adam Burrells, CKPG News.
Vailmont RCMP responded to a weekend collision near Tejon Cache that claimed the life of a person on a motorcycle and injured one person as well. As the temperatures start to warm and more motorcycles are on local roads, the RCMP are taking the opportunity to remind motorists to remain alert and to drive safely. Dave Branco has more.
Two people were on the bike. One sadly was pronounced deceased at the scene while the other was taken to hospital in critical condition.
That from Corporal Madonna Saunderson describing a motorcycle collision near the weigh scales on Highway 16, north of Tejon Cache. The highway was closed for some time as RCMP investigated the collision. Police are urging drivers to be mindful of motorcyclists, especially during this time of year.
While it is the responsibility of every driver, regardless of on a motorbike or in a vehicle, to be aware of your surroundings, watch what's out there. Certainly motorcycles can be hidden in blind spots of vehicles, so please be aware.
Drivers on the road must be cautious and share the roadway.
Certainly this time of year we got spring cleanup on the roads, and that can certainly add road conditions to the mix when traveling on the highways.
According to the coroner's service report, there was an average of 37 motorcyclist deaths per year between 2012 and 2021. Fatal injuries occurred more frequently on Saturday, followed by Sunday.
Certainly when you are traveling on a motorcycle, you are smaller than other vehicles. And certainly it's your responsibility as well to not only see what's out there, but to be seen as well. So make sure all the lights on your bike are working, front and back. If you like to travel with a high-vis vest, by all means wear that. Certainly anything you can do to help others see you.
Drivers of vehicles should always be vigilant and check their blind spots for motorcyclists who may be passing by. Exercise caution while driving, especially when sharing the road with smaller and more vulnerable vehicles.
Whenever you are operating a motor vehicle, certainly be aware of what's around you. Check your rearview mirrors from time to time. Check your blind spots. Certainly make sure you look when you change lanes. Don't assume that there's nothing there. Make sure you adequately check your rearview mirrors and make sure there is nobody in the lane that you want to travel into.
Dave Branco, CKPG News.
Police in BC have officially been given the okay to use a new weapon that the province says aims to minimize injuries and deaths during confrontations. The Ministry of Public Safety says the use of the Taser 7 has been approved after a 9-month field trial that found the model was in fact effective. It says the new weapon offers the ability to discharge a second shot without reloading a new cartridge, as well as a short distance shooting range option, among other enhancements as well. The government says the weapon is already authorized for use in Ontario, Quebec, Nova Scotia, New Brunswick, Saskatchewan, and Alberta. Okay, it's a little bit of a lean agenda for tonight's council meeting. Cheryl Jan joins us now to preview what's on the docket tonight. Now, Cheryl, council will be hearing a pair of delegations, and there are a series of requests for council support in the agenda as well. But let's start with the delegations. What can you say about what council should expect tonight?
Well, the SPCA will be making the presentation. Did you know that the BC SPCA was founded in 1895?
Wow, 1895. Yeah, 1895.
Yeah, and their responsibility is for not just domestic animals, but farm animals and wild animals. So they'll make a presentation at council. It doesn't look like they're asking for anything, but then there's the second delegation, and they're looking for support.
Can you expand on that a little
bit? Yes. They are the Shared Hope Group, and they were formed when the Ukraine crisis came up in February of 2022. Mm-hmm. And they've been working with an organization called the Oasis Settlement Group. And so of the people that have come from Ukraine here, 268 have found home, have decided to call this home. Mm-hmm. 33 have found other opportunities. 8 have returned to Ukraine. But gaps have been identified in settlement services. And so they're asking for a letter of support from the city, from council, to kind of maybe address that deficit.
Now, when you say gaps in terms of services, is this like can you expand that? What do you mean by that?
Just lags in getting home placement, lags in getting, Canadian citizenship, all that kind
visas,
of stuff.
That kind
yeah,
of stuff.
Yeah,
right.
Exactly. Yeah.
One other thing of note, I understand there's a letter of correspondence that seems interesting.
Yes, well, so we did a story about 2 weeks ago where the city, because our vacancy rates were at one point below 3%, so it's called the Rental Accommodation Act. And the province has, it kind of targets Airbnbs, Verbos, that kind of thing, where you got people living there for 3 months, 2 months, whatever.
Short-term rentals.
Exactly, short-term rentals. And so because of the housing shortage, the province introduced this Short-Term Rental Housing Act to kind of get people away from that. And the city wrote to the province to say, hey, we have a lot of transient workers here, pipeline workers, et cetera, et cetera, and they need short-term housing.
Right.
Right. So they applied to the province to opt out of this. The only way you could opt out of it is if you had a vacancy rate of less than 3%. That's based on Canada Mortgage and Housing. And so that's not what you'd call really, yeah, but anyhow, we did have a vacancy rate of over 3% in 2022 and then under 3% in 2023. So we're on that kind of cusp. And now we've been told, no dice. We don't qualify for that. And I'm sure that's going to engage a lot of conversation around council chambers tonight.
Should be very interesting stuff. Yeah. Cheryl Jan, thank you very much for your insight.
Very welcome.
Environment Canada says the community of Burns Lake was under a dust advisory this weekend due to high amounts of particulate matter in the air. Now, the agency said in a special air quality statement that the dust advisory issued by the province's Environment Ministry and the Northern Health Authority on Saturday continued through the weekend. The statement says the dusty conditions will persist unless it rains or if traffic patterns ease, as dust levels are highest near busy roads and industrial facilities. The dust advisory will remain in place for the time being, at least this week. In other news, as part of its annual MVP of the Month campaign, the UNBC Timberwolves were busy all weekend collecting bottles to raise funds for community member Grace Calhoun. Tommy Osborne met with Calhoun to learn more about how impactful this fundraiser will be for her.
Grace Calhoun is a mother of five and a very active community member, but her life changed forever with a recent diagnosis that limited her mobility, meaning she now has to use a wheelchair full-time. Upon learning her story, the UMBC Timberwolves made her the MVP of the month to raise funds to help cover the cost of equipment and healthcare services she may need.
It does mean the world to me because, you know, my kids are in every kind of sport and activity. So getting to be a mom and getting to see them at their events, that's huge for me. Getting to volunteer with 4-H again, that brings so much joy to my heart. It's been a huge change for me to have to be home. I really just want to be out and have that freedom. You know, everyone takes that for granted, but when your life changes suddenly, it's such a different life that you just don't understand what that can be like. So this just gets me a step closer to living my best life.
While the official number isn't known yet, the money raised from the bottles plus a charity dodgeball game later this week typically raises anywhere between $6,000 to $7,000. This type of money would be incredibly impactful to help Grace get back to many of the activities she's used to doing.
Having my independence again would benefit me a lot to get out, and whether I'm volunteering or going to work, unfortunately it all costs money to get the right equipment, whether it's the vehicle, new wheelchair, all of that costs so much and it's so out of reach for me. So all of this really gets me a step closer to my freedom again.
As for the athletes doing what they can to help Grace, they say it's all worth it when you see just how much of a difference it can make.
It's just been really inspiring to see that, and now I want to come out here and do what I can to contribute to that and hopefully just end up making a difference in Grace's life.
One of Grace's friends started a GoFundMe to help her cover the costs of needed equipment, which is also how UMBC learned of her story. Tommy Osborne, CKPG News.
The Wellness North and Business Expo took place over the weekend at the Prince George Civic Center, and one focus across several booths was supporting the physical and mental well-being of seniors. Tommy Osborne reporting once again, he spoke with several organizations to learn how important it is to provide those supports for seniors in our community.
We've seen a growing number of seniors in our community, as just over 16% of Prince George's population is seniors, per the most recent data available from Statistics Canada. With our senior population growing at a faster rate than our ages 0 to 14 population, supporting seniors has become a growing need in our community. This is where organizations like the Prince George Council of Seniors steps in, as it has many programs offering a wide variety of supports.
For example, it's the tax season, so our office is very much busy with helping seniors in terms of like filing for their taxes. So we have volunteer people who are helping out the seniors in terms of filing for their taxes. The Meals and Wheels program has been extended also in terms of like the location of the services that we provide.
The Prince George Council of Seniors helps support seniors' wellness in many ways to make sure they can live comfortably. But beyond services like Meals on Wheels or helping with your taxes, perhaps equally as important is socializing and being involved with the community for your mental well-being. The Council of Seniors has many events to help with the social aspect, and other organizations like the Men's Shed also play a huge role. The Men's Shed is all about providing men, often but not always retired, a place to socialize and do some woodworking projects together.
You think about kind of where men tend to gather, right? And it's watching sports, drinking beer, those kind of things. And we realize that that's not necessarily healthy for our physical bodies or our mental well-being. And so we really need to kind of create a safe place for men to gather.
Gertz was motivated to join when he felt burned out from working as a therapist for 17 years, and his house burning down in 2015 compounded on an already difficult period.
It was a really safe place for me just to chill. And I didn't have the capacity, my brain power, my executive functioning, to even do projects. I just hung out and just watched guys. And that was really the foundation of my recovery journey.
Whether it's mental health or physical well-being, the Wellness Expo showed there are no shortages of services out there to help our senior population. Tommy Osborne, CKPG News.
As of this morning, the lowest gas price in Prince George was sitting at $1.579 per liter at Costco. The lowest price in the province right now is in Salmon Arm at $1.516 per liter. Manitoba currently has the lowest fuel prices on average in Canada at $1.39 per liter, while BC has an average price of $1.872 per liter.
CKPG Sports is delivered by Domino's. Try one of our delicious stuffed cheesy breads, paired up with chicken, pizza, pasta, or dessert for just $8.99 per item.
With the Portland Winterhawks losing on Friday night, the Prince George Cougars found themselves with a golden opportunity to clinch the number one seed in the Western Conference. That means home ice advantage throughout the WHL playoffs. What was standing in their way? The Kamloops Blazers, a team with nothing to lose in front of a big crowd on retro night. Here's how it went down.
Cougars taking on the Kamloops Blazers. Prince George pressing early with a couple of quality chances, but Blazers goalie Jesse Sonch is up to the task, and a back-and-forth period sees it being scoreless after one. In the second period, disaster hits for PG as a tipped puck jumps over the pad of Joshua Ravensbergen. Kamloops on upset alert. It's 1-0. But the lead wouldn't last too long as Riley Height takes this one over. He streaks down the right side and rips a shot blocker side. An absolute beauty, and it's tied. Then just a short time later, he does it again. Becker with a beautiful pass that number 27 tips home, his 36th on the year, and the Cougars with their first lead heading to the third period. But Kamloops won't go away. Just 1:02 into the third, Ashton Furster with his second goal of the night, tying this game at two and silencing the crowd once again. Andre Becker has the answer though, as the import continues his tear against Kamloops, picking up a loose rebound. The Cougars take a 3-2 lead before Riley Height would close this one out. It's a Height trick for number 27 in black and red. Boreas Vallis would add one more goal before the celebrations begin. The Prince George Cougars are your Western Conference champions, led by the team's all-time franchise points leader, who had a couple people wanting to get an interview.
It's nice, I think. It's a team thing again. Like I said, I think it comes right for my team. It's good with Ottoman. It's just good to get this win, and we're gonna enjoy it.
Now we move on. With the number one seed clinched, the Prince George Cougars have found their playoff opponent for round number one, as the Spokane Chiefs come to town for a seven-game series. It will be the same format as last year versus Tri-City, with games one and two in Prince George, games 3, 4, and 5 in Spokane, and games 6 and 7 in Prince George. It's a team they can't take lightly despite the point difference.
Yeah, they're a good team. They got a lot of skill throughout the lineup, and they got a lot of depth on their team and good goalies, and it's going to be a well-matched up series. But kind of what happened in the regular season, kind of just got to take that down and flush it down the toilet. Kind of it's a new season starting here with playoffs, and Both teams are going to be coming in as completely different animals.
It's been a really good year. Like when you break it down and you look at it, right from training camp and our expectations this year that we were going to have a good team. How good, you never know, right? But when you break it all down, I think the biggest thing with this team was consistency.
And there might be another reason that Riley Height was buzzing in Saturday's game, as before the game, the Cougars forward inked a 3-year entry-level contract with the Minnesota Wild. It's a perfect way to cap off a great regular season from the Minnesota Wild prospect. This year, Height had a career-best season. He had 37 goals and 80 assists in just 66 games. In his Cougars career, the 19-year-old has 227 points in 220 WHL games with the Cougars. That's the most points and assists by a Cougars player in franchise history. He was selected by Minnesota in the second round, 64th overall in the 2023 NHL entry draft, and now he sees all of his hard work pay off.
Yeah, it was nice to finally, you know, get that over with, and, you know, super honored, and yeah, I just kind of had some time to reflect today, and just, you know, what it means, you know, to me, for, you know, what my family's done for me, and, you know, my teammates. So yeah, it's a contract in my eyes with, you know, not just myself but my family as well, and, you know, my teammates. So it's you know, super honored, and yeah, I just want to keep getting better every day, and, you know, just keep doing what I can.
The DSX is down 42 points to close at 21,942. The Dow Jones is down 162 points to close at 39,314. And Canfor went down 16 cents to close at $17.39.
Good evening again. We're looking at a wonderful Tuesday ahead, but we'll take you back on our satellite map from earlier today and look at all that clearing. A little bit of high cloud to start, but lots of sunshine, mix of sun and cloud for the afternoon. So now we're in for a couple of different systems that are going to move through the province over the next few days. The first one will likely hit us going into the later part of tomorrow. So you can see we are looking at lots of showers along coastal sections. Futurecast gives you a better idea here. And again, we won't really see anything too major until we get into really the later part of the afternoon. But the next system is the one after that is the one that actually could bring a little more precipitation. So showers are possible late afternoon tomorrow, and then into Wednesday night is when we've got rain developing, which could actually switch over to a chance of some snow going into Thursday. So there's two different systems that are likely to make some precipitation develop through our region. 11 though for our afternoon, mix of sun and cloud for the bulk of the day. Up in Fort St. John, temperatures are way above average for this time of the year in the Peace, 10 degrees there. It's going to be a pretty unsettled day for the next couple of days down through parts of the southern interior. Just chances of showers, not big chances, but certainly a little bit of some bands of moisture coming through the south coast. Of course, inland to Vancouver, getting lots of rain over the next few days. 10 degrees Vanderhoof, 9 in Fort St. James. We're looking at temperatures really above average in many areas. Quesnel, 14 degrees and a sun cloud mix tomorrow. Wow, what a beautiful spring day that is. So there's the west coast. It'll be a wet one at 12. 2 in Edmonton, cloudy skies. -4 in Regina with mainly sunshine. So a much cooler trend through the prairies for the next few days, but certainly the potential for some sunshine is there. Winnipeg will be a bit unsettled tomorrow with some snow falling, -6. And then as we go over towards Montreal, temperatures are wonderful, 12 degrees and sunny sky, and a bit unsettled as we get over to the Maritimes. So a quick look at our big map for you. Sunny skies late into the week, but particularly the weekend at this point looks pretty good. It's kind of too early to jump ahead to the Easter weekend, but some parts of the weekend look pretty good. And we'll keep an eye on that for all the Easter egg hunts out there. And of course, we need to be planning those in advance. So here is our big map. And again, we're going to continue on with just that back and forth weather with bands of moisture both Tuesday late and Wednesday, Thursday as well in some areas. Burns Lake will be partly sunny tomorrow with some showers in the forecast, rather cloudy Wednesday, 9 degrees the high. Very similar forecast for Mackenzie, mainly cloudy is what we're looking at tomorrow with a few sunny breaks. And then through the later part of tomorrow night and into early Wednesday, we have a chance of showers. In McBride, -4 tonight, clear skies, 10, turning cloudy tomorrow. So starting out the day really nice with some sunshine, and then through the afternoon we start to see things cloud over. Wednesday, Thursday look pretty unsettled, even a wintry mix out there, some snow in the forecast, but then nice and dry for the weekend ahead. Quesnel as well, some snow and rain expected on Thursday, Wednesday night and Thursday, lots of cloud cover, but still very mild for a few days, 14 and 13 degrees, and we'll sit around 11 or 12 degrees here in Prince George the next couple of days. So wonderful temperatures, an increase in cloud as we move through the day tomorrow, and again on Wednesday we have the chance of showers both tomorrow evening or late afternoon rather, and into Wednesday evening, and then again that could switch over to a chance of some snow on Thursday.
CKPG Sports is delivered by Domino's. Try one of our delicious stuffed cheesy breads paired up with chicken, pizza, pasta, or dessert for just $8.99 per item.
The Prince George Spruce Kings, they were also in action over the weekend, playing their final two home games of the season. It was the Vernon Vipers handing the team two losses on Friday and Saturday. Prince George outshot them on both games, but couldn't find the back of the net themselves. Killian McGregor-Bennett was responsible for the only Spruce King goal over the weekend, actually. The team now heads to Vernon and Merritt for their final two games of the BCHL regular season. And then preparations start for the Penticton Bees. That series in round one of the playoffs begins shortly. Prince George has had a rich history of hockey players having success at the junior level. Nico Mijatovic, Cameron Schmidt, and Chase Harrington, to name a few, in this year alone. But the latter two left Prince George at a young age to play hockey elsewhere for better development opportunities. But now an organization in town is taking a step forward in keeping talent in Prince George. Anthony Correa explains.
It's something that happens too often. Talented hockey players leaving the North at a young age to find better development opportunities. While Northern Ice Sports is looking to change that, announcing its new program of excellence for kids to stay in town and get the proper training needed to take the next step in their career.
We really think that there's an opportunity for U9 through U13 to be able to develop these kids that can then transition to the PGSS hockey program. By developing the kids for these programs, it's keeping kids local and it's allowing us to have some homegrown talent that hopefully will play for the Spruce Kings and hopefully will play for the Cougars and you know, see their dreams come through.
Former Spruce King Kevin Martin will be one of the coaches in the program and is looking forward to providing insight to a smaller group of kids, which can make it easier to focus on the smaller things while keeping kids in town.
They get more time touching the puck, more time developing their skills in a smaller group. And our goal is to develop these kids so they can develop and graduate into the PGSS program, into the AAA, and we have a Junior A team, we have a WHL team, like we have everything here. Unless you're drafted and have to go somewhere else as a WHL player, you can be here your whole hockey career.
The first set of programming starts in April to help youth get ready for tryouts, with the goal to have the academy-type program up by September to get kids the needed ice time here in Prince George.
The players get three ice times a week and two dryland sessions to work on all their skills, hockey development, and the mobility off the ice and strength and how to stretch properly and that stuff.
We have seen situations where kids have left town because they haven't felt that there is the development opportunities here. And that's something we want to stop because we truly believe there is.
Registration and details are on the Northern Ice Sports webpage. Anthony Correa, CKPG News.
It was a Sunday fun day full of sports yesterday, so we bring you the best from yesterday's action, including two NHL players who continue to rack up goals. It's all here in tonight's CKP3.
Starting with a moonshot.
In the swing at the slider, the back foot again. Not right there.
Not there. Swung on, hit a mile way out of here to right center. And the Orioles on that swing add on to their lead at 6-2.
Adley Rutschman destroys his third home run of spring training, 460 feet, and he's ready for opening day. Next, it's 5-0 for Hyman.
The same holds true.
Here's a tap in, McDavid, and that's 50 for Zach Hyman, and his teammates mob him as he becomes the seventh Oiler to score all 50 in an Edmonton sweater in a single season. And even the crowd here, which is highly populated with blue and orange, letting Zach Hyman know they appreciate half a hundred.
The Oilers' Zach Hyman reaches the 50-goal plateau for the first time in his NHL career. An incredible season for a special player. Finally, Ovi on a roll.
2 points. Blocker has dinner reservation.
Yeah.
Send in Ovechkin. Backhand. Score! Another multi-goal game for the Grade 8, and he celebrates with his son.
Alex Ovechkin gets his third multi-goal game in his last four. He's up to 848 on his career as he continues to close the gap between the great one, and he also takes top spot in tonight's CKP3.
hello from the CKPG Today side. Got a great one coming up over here, including a kickoff, an official kickoff of our contest for the Champions of Magic, giving away tickets for you, your family, to go watch them at CN Center. Of course, they're coming up here in April. And, well, who do we get to kick it off? Well, a local magician slash clown coming to the studio today. Got some great magic tricks, far better than anything I could conjure up. So they're going to stop by today. And we're going to debut a new segment called What Does Chad Have? Going down to the Exploration Archives to learn what Chad has today. How about you over there? Have you ever played a clown or a magician? Are you any good at that kind of stuff?
You know, I'm known to break out a card trick here and there at a dinner party or something like that, but nothing really on that level. I'm sure your guests will be much better than anything I can conjure up. But to finish up our show today, we have the second edition of Forever Friends, and this week Sam Bennison went to the PG Animal Rescue to meet Mocha the mare. Take a look.
Mocha came into the care of the PG Animal Rescue last year. This enchanting equine is well-mannered and loves being around kids.
She's quite interesting that adults might spook her more, but small children, she just gravitates to and loves them, and her past owner, just a little boy about this high, and he could do anything with her. And she's just so sweet. It's like they understand, you know, and it's somebody that they need to be gentle with.
Mocha is very healthy and was only surrendered because the original owner could not properly train her.
Unfortunately, she was too complicated for the owner. So green rider, green horse, not a good mix.
At 12 years old, Mocha hasn't learned to ride, but while you might not be able to teach an old dog new tricks, this middle-aged quarter horse mix has gotten a few laps in, and now it's just practice, practice, practice.
We want her to have that future as a riding horse, not just as a companion horse. She's safe every other way, but for the riding part, it takes a lot more training.
If Mocha is the magnificent mare of your dreams, you can adopt her via pganimalrescue.com. Sam Bennison, CKPG News.
Let's hope Mocha finds her forever home. But that's all for tonight, folks. Thanks so much for joining us, as always. And we will see you tomorrow. Have yourselves a wonderful night.